Yo, what's up, guys? In today's video, I have a very interesting topic that I want to talk about. The Chicago Bulls have been getting so much hate from the NBA media, especially around the whole DeMar DeRozan sign and trade. But before I jump into today's video, make sure you guys are subscribed to the channel. Check out my last video if you guys missed it. And leave a quick like on today's video and some comments and questions below today's video. And leave a like if you guys do believe the Chicago Bulls won NBA free agency, because just a few weeks back I made a video saying how the Chicago Bulls are winning free agency. And let's just jump right into it, because the Chicago Bulls have been getting so much hate from the NBA media. And I saw an ESPN poll just came out the other day where NBA executives and scouts voted on what was the best and the worst move in this past offseason. And NBA executives and scouts voted the Kyle Lowry to Miami Heat as the best move of the NBA offseason. And I understand that. But then they voted DeMar DeRozan to the Chicago Bulls as the worst. And, you know, this is only the start of it. You guys are going to want to watch this whole video. And I just don't understand this. You know, Kyle Lowry, I do believe he fits pretty solid in Miami. But for them to then say the DeMar to Chicago Bulls signing or sign and trade was the worst, I don't understand that. You know, DeMar, sure, we might have overpaid a little bit for him, but that's the price you pay for another all-star to pair with Zach, Vooch, Lonzo in the NBA. You know, it definitely hurts giving up Thaddeus Young, a future first, and a second, but the Bulls are tired of just drafting 7th overall every year. You know, those draft picks honestly mean nothing. On pretty much every draft pick that we have drafted with the 7th pick has been a bust or not that good in the NBA. And looking back at these contracts, you know, the DeMar DeRozan contract isn't that bad, so I don't understand the hate there either. You know, I do understand the whole, like, questionable fit and defense, like, comments, but even DeMar was talking to the Bulls media and he said, you know, the only people that say that or talk about that are people that have not played basketball or just don't know the game. So I'm very happy to hear that from him, because usually when you add all-stars together or just stars, they usually learn how to play off one another and play with each other. So back to what I was saying, onto DeMar's contract. You know, he is 32 right now, and for his next 3 seasons with the Bulls, he'll be making 26, 27, and 28. You know, that's a little much, but if you then look at the Kyle Lowry signing, I believe that signing might be the worst. You know, he is 35 already, and for these next 3 seasons with Miami, he will be making 27, 28, and then 29. Pretty much $30 million per season for Kyle Lowry, who's 35, compared to DeMar, who's 32 only. And I think it's obvious DeMar is the way better player right now. I mean, he's just had his best season in the NBA with the Spurs. You know, he is a 4-time All-Star. He did average 21 points and 7 assists a game this past year. So I just don't understand how that's the worst move of the offseason. So definitely leave some comments and questions below today's video about that first topic. And let's just jump right into the second video, because this just keeps getting worse and worse. I'll make sure to throw up a little clip of it right now. But pretty much the jump was really just hating on the Chicago Bulls.
I think they increased their chances only to a point, though. And George, this is what stuns me, having covered Jerry and Michael Reinsdorf for years and years. That was an ownership group that did not want to go all in to potentially be a team that got bounced in the first or second round of the playoffs. Well, guess what they just did? They went completely all in on a team that at its highest ceiling maybe gets to the second round of the postseason. So I'm still surprised. I know Karnisovas and Eversley are trying to do their own thing in that front office, and I know fans are excited. But when I look at that team in comparison to the rest of the East, I just don't think they improved that much where you can start looking at them going, oh, okay, I see them having a legitimate chance to get up to the top of the Eastern Conference.
Look, my guy Nick has covered the Bulls for a long time, and he nailed it on the head. The Bulls have gone all in on 2 sub-all-star 30-year-old guys in Nick Vucevic and DeMar DeRozan to try to keep a guy in Zach LaVine who has never been on a winning team and now is going to be a free agent in the year and could leave. And I think there's a real chance the Bulls don't even make the play-in tournament. You know, when you talk about this depth in the Eastern Conference, I think they could finish 11th or 12th very easily. They're going to have a terrible defense. And you look at the way this team is built, like, yes, those guys are durable, but I do not see them having any kind of high ceiling. And now they can't trade a draft pick until, what, 2030, 2040? I mean, they've just put themselves in a box for what? For no high ceiling at all. It's just, like Nick said, it's baffling after all the painstaking rebuild they went to not keep Jimmy Butler, who is, by the way, better than all of these guys they have. It's just really strange what the Bulls have set themselves up with here.
And first off, Nick was really hating on the Bulls making these moves. He said, you know, fans are excited. I'm very excited because this team has so much potential because they have an older core in DeMar Vucinic. And say that fails, they have a backup plan and a younger core in Patrick Williams, Kobe White, and LaVine and Lonzo. I just don't understand the hate. And in the video, they said that they might not even make the play-in tournament. You know, that's just so disrespectful. I know they get paid to say like crazy and bold things that are going to get people talking and just piss people off pretty much. But come on, man. This team not being like a play-in or even making the playoffs or in the play-in tournament, that's ridiculous. And even if this team honestly gets destroyed with injuries, which I hope not, I still believe this team is a playoff team in the East. And they also were bashing the whole DeMar and Vooch signings and trades. You know, they said they went all in on two sub all-stars that are about 30 years old. You know, this is just ridiculous. I know the Bulls defense might not be the greatest, but to not even make the play-in tournament and then bash on Vooch and DeMar, it just doesn't make sense. Ain't no way they're gonna fall below the 10th seed without an injury. And the Bulls' third option is a guy that's averaging 22 points per game and 7 assists a game, and he's an all-star caliber player. It's just ridiculous, man. I don't know why they hire these guys and let them talk about the NBA. And let's just take a moment and realize this. They wouldn't be calling them sub all-stars if the Lakers made these moves. Or say DeMar went to the Lakers or Clippers or someone else traded for Vooch. It's just because it's the Bulls. They love to hate. And obviously it's all about chemistry, but this team has a lot of potential. Like I said, they have an older core and a younger core just in case the older core doesn't work out. They have backup plans. They have a bunch of all-stars on this roster. Lonzo Ball is a great defender. Sure, the defense isn't going to be the best, but how much worse can it be than the past few seasons now? You know, this video was just pretty much 2 minutes of them just trying to destroy the Bulls and just be mad at them. I don't understand it. And then they also brought up Jimmy Butler. You know, the Athletic Guard Packs is still running the show, and they're the ones that traded Jimmy Butler. ESPN is just a bunch of clowns. You know, it's just annoying. And last season, if Zach LaVine never got COVID or whatever and the NBA held him out for 2 to 3 weeks, they easily would have made the play-in tournament, in my opinion. And with the roster they had last year, more than likely going to make the play-in tournament. Then look at this year's roster. Look at how much they upgraded and such. I just don't understand the hate. Same with Stephen A. Smith. You know, of course, he's a Knicks fan, so he's jealous of the Bulls' legacy and everything we've done. He also said, I don't like the combination of DeMar and Zach. He doesn't think it's going to work. You know, he then said one or the other, yes, but not both of them together. I just don't understand. You know, he said that the Knicks have a brighter future than the Bulls, but let's be honest, the Knicks were reportedly interested in Lonzo and DeMar, and the Bulls stole both of them from the Knicks. I just don't understand the hate. Especially the whole hate on DeMar and Vooch. You know, they both had their best season. Sure, they're getting up there a little bit in age. Like I said, they would have made the play-in tournament if Zach never got injured. It just annoys me. It pisses me off. I know they get paid to say these things, but at the same time, I'm very excited for this Bulls season. Definitely leave some comments and questions below today's video talking about all the topics I talked about. And leave some record predictions and just predictions below today's video as well. Thank you guys for watching today's video. Have a good one.